So I'm joined here today by Lee Radford, who's a photographer for the Brighton Fringe Festival, which is going to take place next May. And welcome to Latest TV,
Thank
Lee.
You.
So you've got some exhibits there, I think, for the exhibition.
I have.
Yeah. I think you're just going to quickly show that.
We are starting a project called Unframe Lives.
Yeah.
Which is a photo elicitation project involving the homeless and austerity and the welfare state. This is in connection with my Brighton and Hove photo project,
yeah,
who's been running a photo calendar for the last 6 months to 8 months now, and which is available, trying to exhibit the views and perspectives of those that have experienced homelessness around the city of Brighton.
And this exhibition, you've had a really interesting journey to becoming a photographer. I know you've experienced homelessness yourself, and to be where you are now, exhibiting at the Brighton Fringe Festival, that's a really extraordinary journey. So did you just want to say a few words about, you know, about that journey?
Sure. 7 years ago now, I was homeless on the streets of Brighton for about a three-year period of time, through to illness and a series of mistakes. It took another 4 years after that 3 years of being homeless to try and bring myself back down to a sense of sort of social reality, from overexposure, sensory overload from when I was homeless, and dealing with the illness itself. How I managed to arrive in the position I am now is through a series of hard work, meeting the right people, accessing services that offered me a creative outlet. I can't overstate the power it has to be able to show your work to the general public,
yeah,
when you're surviving homelessness. It gave me a connection to mainstream society and started showing me avenues of ways that I could escape being homeless.
Yeah. And what are you hoping to achieve with this exhibition for the Brighton Fringe?
The project hopes to bring to the forefront views and perspectives of those that have experienced homelessness in all of its facets around the city of Brighton, focusing on lived experiences. So the realities of living homeless, rather than the perception or the public emotional knowledge of what it's like to be homeless.
And does this involve working with certain communities in Brighton Hove? I mean, there's a homeless communities which you have close contact with on a regular basis, or is it more kind of random? Is there a kind of a structured approach?
It's a little bit more of a random approach. We are using partners around Brighton and Hove, so services like One Church,
yeah,
to gain access to people that have lived experiences of homelessness. We visit them, we discuss the projects with them, and if they would like to share those lived experiences, then we offer photography workshops and research interviews to try and pull out from the images that are created perspectives and views on ways of living as a homeless person.
Okay, and so this is going to be, this exhibition will be next May. Is there any other projects you're working on at the moment, or is this just a one-off piece for Brighton? I think you have other projects.
Well, I do lots of projects. I volunteer as a photographer for many different events,
yeah,
all volunteer-related events, just like our project itself. It's all volunteer-led non-profit organisations. So I'm constantly, I doubt you'd necessarily see my name next to an image, but I'm constantly being published by small event groups that are trying to have impact on social issues around Brighton.
Great, okay, so your exhibition, it's Brighton Fringe Festival next May.
Yes.
It's at the One Church.
The static display is at One Church on Gloucester Road.
That's Gloucester Road in,
yeah,
Brighton.
Yeah, yeah.
Have you got a website, or where can we find out more about your work?
You can find out my work, I'm posting on my Twitter feed at the moment, so you can connect with that's Lee Radford,
yep,
or at Craft the World.
Okay.
If you'd like to just click onto that social media, or you can go to My Brighton Photo Project and get in touch with us through there as well.
Great. Okay, Lee, it's a really inspirational story, so thank you for coming into Latest TV.
Thank you for your time.
So homelessness for me and how I survived it, I guess I need to start at the beginning. For many years, I reflect maybe back into my early teens. was undiagnosed with hypothyroidism. The thyroid can have profound effect on your anxiety levels, your physical health, and generally how you think. After a period of time of suffering with this disease, I ended up making lots of mistakes in my life, hurting others around me, and being in a state of almost permanent anxiety. When you're in those kinds of frames, most of your decisions, or at least most of my decisions, were based on almost an overthinking. So after a few years in my 20s of overthinking and a little bit of substance misuse to buffer out that anxiety, I made too many mistakes and became homeless. Homelessness for me consisted of 3 years of street sleeping, rough sleeping, punctuated occasionally by accessing certain services, but generally being sent away from my support network. So a lot of the time, I would find places to sleep, like on the beach. Now, why would you sleep on the beach?
Because in the middle of the night, you can hear people coming,
which is a survival mechanism. And that's what your psyche turns to. Washed away are the things you would usually do during the day. Cleaning your kitchen, going to work, caring for others, all washed away. And you end up having to survive moment by moment. Those survival instincts become more prevalent as time goes along. From overexposure to the weather, overload of sensory. I ended up isolating myself to try and find a sense of shelter for my mind. So after 3 years of living like that, I managed to find some advancement in helping me with my illness and joined a charity for which I volunteered. In exchange for working when I could, I was offered food and shelter. So that was a really good starting point for me. And the charity itself endeavoured to be creative in their outlook towards what they were doing, which gave me the opportunity to explore the arts, which was the form of nourishment I needed. I really can't overstate the impact it has when you have your work shown to the public. It doesn't just offer self-worth, it offers a communication path between you, your work, and the people that are viewing your work. It also provides a bridge between you and society. For me, I bought out of society when I became homeless. I felt so isolated that it didn't feel like society really cared. And only until I started buying back into society did I understand that people do care. I now spend a lot of time volunteering as a photographer for many events all over Brighton. The amount of people I meet that volunteer for good causes here is inspirational. And that, along with the public viewing of my works and certain friends I met along the way, started pulling me out of homelessness. So, snapshot 6 years down the line, I found help managing my disease, hypothyroidism. I found employment, enough to pay my rent, spending a lot of my time volunteering, which actually makes me feel like a success. How we quantify success varies between individual and individual. For me, it's positively engaging with society and trying to have an impact within society. I feel now that society has helped me, and it's not a form of payback, but a form of balance, that I choose to offer my services
to volunteer organisations that work for good causes.
The most recent project I'm helping co-organise is Unframed Lives, a photo elicitation research document exploring the lived experiences of homeless people in relation to the welfare state during times of austerity. Running side by side with my Brighton & Hove photo project, who explore narratives from people that have experienced homelessness. We have a set exhibition at One Church at Gloucester Road during May 2019 at the Fringe Festival events in Brighton. But what we really would like to do is find the funding for outside projected display of these images to be able to engage with the wider public. We're still looking for funding for this, and I've opened a Just Giving page underneath my name, Lee Radford, to try and gather some funds for this project. Please do get in touch if you think you can help us in any way. If you go to Google and type Lee Radford Photography, I'm sure you'll find me, and I'll be glad to speak to you. Thank you for listening to my story.